Hey everybody, thanks for watching the channel. Today is going to be the final video shoot on the second shell station that we're doing for a client in O scale with Howard. This is the final build on it, so let's take a look. Howard, how you doing?
Good. Was it morning or afternoon?
It's afternoon.
It's 102 degrees outside, and when you're this kind of weather, you're lucky you have an indoor hobby. You don't want to be outside.
Right.
And
right.
In the winter, when it's snowing and crap like that, you don't want to be outside. So this hobby is great. All seasons.
Right. It's an all season.
Thank God for that. Mm.
Let's see. This is the second shell station.
It's the second shell. It's the third gas station of the California order. Mm.
And, wow, very nice. And what we're going to do here, let's just spin it around if we could. Here, you want to spin it, Howard? No.
Sure.
And Howard's going to add a little pastel weathering on it.
Well, I'm going to do the fascia first.
Okay.
Now, this building is very, very typical of what you would find from the 30s up through probably the 50s, which is my era, and most people remodeling love that era, except these new youngsters are getting into this modern stuff.
Right.
Which I've had as much interest in that as, well, jumping out a window at a, it doesn't do much for you.
Hey, everybody has their own taste, but...
Well, get back to locomotives. You talked about this modern stuff, these Gevos and these all kinds of AC-44, whatever these things are. Quite frankly, all they are is bricks on trucks.
Well, we won't...
A steam locomotive has pash, it has sex appeal, and everyone's different. You see the motion. And the old industrial design thing is form follows function, or function follows form, whichever way you want to put it.
Right.
And you see the rotating rods, that's all really interesting.
But
then again, these people never saw steam and the early stuff. So that they model what they know, and that's fine. They're in the hobby, and that's great. They're getting a lot of fun out of it.
Yeah, that's all that matters. Well, let's see. Let's go ahead and start pasteling this thing.
We'll start with the, just do the, do a light ink over the white.
We've done some videos before, folks, but I thought it would be good to...
Here's the original photograph, which was an HO scale model. This still isn't finished, but it's for all practical purposes the model is finished. Now you don't want to always carry a napkin or a paper towel to blot when you blot it has that beautiful look to it.
Right. And let me come around and let's get an aerial view. Let me go ahead and pause this. All right, Howard, we got a ponytail shot.
There you go. I love the ponytail.
Go ahead and re-explain what you were saying there.
Well, we don't want to put too much, because if I put ink and alcohol on this, you're not going to really see it. And the shell signs, I'm a little afraid of doing ink and alcohol on that. So we're just going to dull down the white fascia just a little bit with alcohol and ink. Now, this is my light mixture.
Right.
I have two. I have light and dark. These ends of the roof caps will be painted black eventually.
Okay.
Now, all these models will be finished with scenery dioramas. I'll be a scenery diorama of all kinds of goodies on it.
Right. Let me turn this. Now, earlier, folks, we made a video on doing roads on my channel. And the same weathering technique applied to making these roads. You shoot at concrete. I think you used a matte,
You put
concrete.
It on here, while it's drying, if you just leave it on there, it's going to look terrible.
Right.
So what you want to do is get that mottled concrete look. Yeah, it's done like this here.
Blot it while the
blot
alcohol
is
wet. Mm-hmm. We have another video on that on the channel you can watch. And this is your concoction, your stain. You just
now,
mixed
what
up.
What I'm doing now is, well, this is 99% alcohol. And India ink.
Okay. But the wood, the brown, it's a mixture of your own stain.
Oh, yeah. Took a while to mix that up. The formula is for sale. I'm not giving it away.
Right.
No, I'm just kidding. Anybody wants the formula, I'll be glad to tell them. The 100 line stains are excellent, actually. The only problem is during this period, I ran out of medium brown, so I had to make something up. This is the latrine that goes out here.
Right.
And all I'm doing now is taking the white and bringing the color into scale. Now, if I put this on here, you're not going to see much, see? Mm-hmm. When that dries, you won't see anything.
Right.
I can do the doors. Again, you won't see it. This alcohol in the ink works best with lighter colors. Mm-hmm.
And the roof was dry brushed with the antique white paint.
Yeah, it's rolled roof. Okay, now we're ready for the road. Now, remember, in weathering a building, subtlety is very, very important, if not mandatory. Because once you screw it up, again, as I said, anything can be fixed, but why make things difficult for you?
Right.
Now, when this thing is glued down, we'll get more detail around here. Now, let me show you the interior. A lot of these buildings will have interiors, and this is the way we'll do it. Sort of like a shadow box. Look in here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow.
That's the inside of an old gas station.
Yeah, look at that.
Now, that's going to be lit, and we'll have people in front of that. When I say people, I'm talking about artista figures, not Chinese figures.
Right. Good quality figures.
Good, good, best. Only the best. This will be glued down, obviously. Those are the gas pumps. Now, Al, you built these gas pumps. You did a hell of a job.
Thank you.
Okay, now we can start with the road. We'll pull this little son of a bitch out of here.
These are nice cars.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we've got all kinds of nice cars. Each diorama will have a mess of cars, people, trees, bushes, rocks, all kinds of good stuff. I still have to add a little trim to this building, but that'll come out when we do the diorama. Now, here, we'll go to a light color first. I think I have a, this is a dark gray. So it's,
one of them is bluish, a bluish color. But you're using the black. You're using the
white
black.
Use out of the way. Now, when you go over the cracks, it fills it in nice. This is just a, now, cars will be backing into the station here. So let's go ahead and put the, sort of like that here.
Right. Logical.
You see that? All right.
Yep. Yep. Logical. Logical.
Logical. Now, this is a two-bay.
Plus, you want to make sure the width of the tire tracks match the cars. That's just, that's a no-brainer. Yeah. That's a no-brainer.
They'll be overlapping so many times that it won't make any difference.
Mm-hmm. Just some marks.
Now, there'll be scenery coming through here. The road will be over here.
Mm-hmm. Right.
There's a guy who made a U-turn. He saw the prices, and he said, holy shit, I'm out of here.
Right, I'm gone.
It's all 22 cents a gallon. Too expensive for him, so he made a U-turn. You can see the skid marks.
Yep. It's a nice building. It's not that big. It's O-scale, but it looks like the whole diorama here is about 24 inches by maybe a foot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
maybe 14 inches.
That's good for now.
You know, Howard, we didn't get to do this on my highway video because the paint was not fully dry.
You got to let the paint dry. That's important. Now, we can put some on these pumps over here. That would make sense.
Not too much.
No, that's cool. You can always take it off.
Right.
It's not a problem. Now, when you make these poles to get these to fit, you make the pole a little bit shorter so you can slide it up and down in this base so you get a perfect fit.
All right.
And after you get that, just put it right in place. Right.
Glue it in place.
Yeah, that's all.
Yeah.
When it's set up, then you just glue it. Hit it with a plastic cement.
Very nice.
Now, we can put a little more on the fascia, even though the white is dulled down. But we can lock this over here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's a good shot.
Don't want to overdo it.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't really do this stuff well until I had my ponytail.
Right.
I wish you could be here. Well, you'll be here Friday. You can film my daughter's reaction when she sees my ponytail.
I just got a haircut, so I got to grow my hair.
Yeah, you look shoveled. Shoveled and kempt. You got to be careful. You're going to look like a Republican. That'll probably piss people off.
Oh, yeah, we won't go.
Now, let's try this over here. Let's try the shell sign. We'll have dirt around the top.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah.
Again, you got to be very careful. These took a while to cut out, and I don't want to mess these up.
Mm-hmm. They look cut out a little bit better than paper glued on, because if you when you cut them out, they have more of a dimension to them. They look like a real metal sign.
Well, with the paper, now George Cellulis was the first to actually put the paper, thin the paper out with sandpaper, thin it out, mm-hmm. then use his fingernail to rub it into the brick or wood or whatever, and that was good. Mm-hmm. That's something that it's the first time I've seen that technique.
You put these on what, cardstock or on
styrene?
Styrene. Keep them from warping.
It's easy to cut.
Right.
Now that works out all right.
And it gives you that little bit of a depth.
Yeah. Okay, that works. Now we'll do the rest of the signs.
That really made a big difference on the sign. It was a little nuclear when we first saw it.
Again, when we do the diorama, that's where we'll do all the completion of the weathering. See, there's still stuff to leave. We got to put a piece of trim here and trim over here, mm-hmm. which will be fine.
Gutter maybe or something. Yeah. Or just trim.
No, we'll just get this over here. Now, let's get the latrine. I like thick fascia because it really sets the building off. Mm-hmm. If your fascia, a lot of people, including you, my friend,
right,
leave fascias off.
Well, I never knew. I've got folks. I have about 75 structures on my layout that need fascia. So,
one winter day,
I'm going to sit down and I'm going to start my fascia.
Well, if you want to exaggerate something, exaggerate the fascia, because it really looks good.
Right.
Okay. That's about...
Yeah, this looks totally different than it did when we first started the video. Yeah. I'm liking the... It has a much different...
Well, you see how quick this goes, because obviously it's going to fit into your short video.
Yeah.
Now, I assume you'll film the dioramas when we do them.
Absolutely, yeah. That's going to be an upcoming series, folks.
Now, this client apparently is pretty happy because he just ordered 8 more buildings. Yeah. So it's...
Now, are you going to weather the garage doors a little bit or no?
Oh, yeah. Not too much. Let's see.
See, the temptation is to go overboard. That's my problem.
Well, remember we talked about knowing when to stop?
Right.
Okay, don't want to overdo the roads. That's fine. Okay, we'll put this little sumbitch back in here and put this sumbitch over here.
Very nice.
And there we go. Then figure that, try to imagine that with scenery, trees, rocks, sand, tires, Coke machines, all the lots of people.
A splendid presentation. Well, folks, if you want this built for you, you can contact us at alpug1@verizon.net and do them HO.
Or O.
Or O, or even S scale.
I've done S scale, but it's difficult.
Right.
Let's try this other shell. Let's see what happens if we do this sign here. We'll use the lighter color.
Yeah, the shell station,
I don't know. There we go. These are cutout letters. Now, these letters, you can buy these, believe it or not, on Amazon. Mm-hmm. Dial up, cut out letters.
Wow.
And they have a hell of a selection.
These particular letters. 3/4 inch?
These come from England.
Okay.
And they're just quite lovely.
And they stick out.
Yeah. You want to get the. That's good. Yeah, now let's get this good thing over here. Now, one of the reasons I don't want to put the overdo this, because it's going to have a different look when we get the scenery in, mm-hmm. the dioramas. So we want to adjust this.
This really went from being kind of mm-hmm. on the dull side to really popping, I think.
Now this door would be dirty, so it'll put a little dirt in the door. Mm-hmm. And let's get this one over here.
Watch American Pickers, folks. That's
a good show. That's a good show.
And they find these Shell station signs all the time, and they go nuts every time they find a.
Well, they also found a set of what they thought were expensive Lionel trains.
Mm-hmm. And I saw that episode. And
they got screwed.
They overpaid big time.
Way overpaid. Which means you have to know what the hell you're doing.
Yeah.
Remember what I told you about investment? You need three things for an investment. You need thorough knowledge, thorough belief, and mostly control. Control as much as you can of your investment. Then you got it. Those guys knew nothing about what they were doing, and they got screwed. Well, okay, that looks good.
That looks good.
That turns out fine.
Yep.
That was a little fun.
Turn it around, and that'd be the...
Okay.
Folks, I appreciate you watching it. Again, if you want one of these built, if you want a price, contact me at alpug1@verizon.net. We don't sell them as kits. We sell them built up. And contact us. Howard, thanks.
You're quite welcome, Al.
And folks, if you like what you see, please hit the like button. The like button helps push these videos out. It's a little thumbs up button. If you can hit that like button for me, it makes a big difference on YouTube. And if you can subscribe, it's free, and you can see our ongoing series on these buildings. Thanks so much.